The unopinionated nature of React is a two-edged sword. On the one hand, you get freedom of choice. On the other hand, many projects end up with a custom and often messy architecture. This video is the eighth part of a series about software architecture and React apps, where we take a code base with lots of bad practices and refactor it step by step. See my playlist named React Architecture for more videos and check the description of this video for the source code and the corresponding blog post. Previously, we separated our application into domain, infrastructure, application and UI layer. But we didn't introduce one of the most important tools in production React apps yet, React Query or another server state management library. That's the topic of this video. Before we start, a quick side note. I won't go through the setup of React Query, nor will I explain its features in detail. I assume you're familiar with that. If not, you can use the docs or one of the many tutorials out there. Also, if you haven't watched the other videos of this series, I recommend doing so before you continue. Anyway, let's have a look at a problematic code example. Here's a component that fetches the currently signed in user and renders a form in a dialog that allows the user to reply to a message, aka shout. So what's the problem? If you ever used React Query, you probably know the problem. We manually manage the loading and error state, which leads to boilerplate code. At the same time, we don't even cache the API response, which will lead to duplicate API requests. These are just two things that React Query can help us with. So what's the solution? We introduce a hook based on React Query that manages the data fetching for us. This is a fairly standard implementation. In the query hook, we call the service method. Now we can simply use the new query hook instead of the use effect in the component. We not only can remove a lot of boilerplate code, like the error and loading state handling, we also get response caching, retries, and a lot more features out of the box. To summarize, we use the query hook as sort of proxy between the component and the service layer. Okay, this was a pretty simple example, but what about something more complex? Let's have a look at another problematic code example that contains business logic. In the previous code example, we didn't look at the submit handler. Here it is. In a previous video, we extracted a bunch of business logic from the submit handler into the use reply to shout hook. The hook simply provides a couple of service functions to the reply to shout function by dependency injection. So what's the problem? The reply to shout function sends multiple API requests, among them calls to userService.getMe and userService.getUser. But this data has already been fetched in other parts of the app and thus exists in the React query cache. Additionally, we again have to manage the loading state manually. Again, the solution is to use our React query data and mutations. In the previous example, we already introduced a query hook useGetMe. Let me quickly add the remaining hooks for the queries and mutations required here. Now we can use these hooks inside the use reply to shout hook. As a first step, we replace the dependencies object by a TypeScript interface that matches the data and mutation functions of our React query hooks. Next, we adjust the reply to shout function accordingly. Next, we need to rewrite the use reply to shout hook. Instead of simply providing the dependencies object to the reply to shout function and returning it, we need to change things a bit. First, we gather all dependencies via the query and mutation hooks. Then, we return an object with a mutate async function. The name is random, but makes the API of the hook consistent with the React query mutation hooks. Next, we merge the loading states of all the query and mutation hooks. And we merge the errors of both query hooks. With this change, the API request to get me and the recipient are sent as soon as the reply dialog component is rendered. At the same time, both responses can be delivered from the cache if the data has been fetched previously. Once the user replies to a shout, they don't have to wait for these requests anymore, improving their overall user experience. Another advantage of this approach, while we use React Query for server data management, we can test the reply to shout function and all its business logic in isolation. With these changes, we can now simplify our reply to dialog component. First, we pass a recipient handle to the hook. Then we need to call the mutate async function inside the submit handler. Now we can remove the isLoading state as this is provided by the adjusted useReplyToShout hook. Another advantage of extracting the business logic to the useReplyToShout hook becomes obvious now. We changed the underlying mechanism of server data management inside the hook quite a bit, but still the adjustments in the component were minimal. That was it for this time. we successfully integrated React Query into our React application's architecture. Next time, we'll refactor the folder structure a bit to match a more common feature-driven folder structure.